Is the stock market repeating the 2019 price action, and could it be making its way back up to the all-time high? In this stock market update and analysis, we will review the stock market internals, its sentiment indicators, and the price action of the S&P 500 to see what the market is telling us and what we could expect from the market in the coming week. Before I continue, let me remind you to click the thumbs up if you find the content in this video to be useful and informative. And click the subscribe if you are not a subscriber to this channel. The stock market continued to move up last week. The S&P 500 closed the week at 2,874.56. Last week, the S&P 500 gained almost 85 points, or just slightly above the 3%. And from the March 23rd low, the S&P 500 have regained 682.7 points, or slightly above 31%. And if you look at the level right now off the high back in February, it is only off a little bit more than 15%, or 513 points. Let's go take a look at the market internal and its sentiment indicator to see what the market is telling us. The S&P 500 put in a higher high last week. It closed at a higher high on Friday, but the advanced decline did not put in a higher high. So we need to watch that in the coming week to see whether it set up a negative diversion to tell us that we should be on the lookout for a potential pullback. And the New York Stock Exchange new high, new low, still hovering near this neutral line, although we are getting a little bit positive here, a few positive on the new high, new low. We will need to monitor this to see what it continue to improve as the market continue to push higher. The put call ratio is still above the 0.75, and it is getting a bit more bullish. We'll need to see what it be able to drop below this 0.75 in the coming week as the market continue to move higher. The VIX did not make a lower low as the S&P 500 made a higher high. Although it did come down substantially from the 80 plus level, and it is still sitting at a relatively elevated level at 38.15. So it's still pretty much risk off. So in the coming week, we're going to see would it be able to dip back into maybe the low 20 or possibly under the 20 to see will it get back into the risk on as the market push higher. Looking at the New York Stock Exchange up-down volume ratio, the up-down volume ratio came up to plus 9.14, so it's relatively strong to support the rally on Friday. From this review of the stock market internals and its sentiment, one can conclude the stock market is still leaning toward the upward bias. Although the cumulative advanced decline and the VIX are showing some negative divergence, but until we get a confirmation, we should remain cautious and manage the stop to lock in our profit. Now let's go take a look at the price action of the S&P 500 and see what we could expect in the coming week. Here looking at the daily chart of the S&P 500. Remember last week's video, we were talking about this potential evening star type of pattern. If we got a down day on Monday, then we expect to see maybe we get a little pullback and come down to this 100%, somewhere around the 2637.06. Then we see would it be able to push back up to this 161 at the 2912.19. But instead, we did get the negative down day on Monday, but we did not get a follow through to come down to test this 2637. Instead, it came up, move above the 141 and got above the 2821.37 before it came down and chopped around just right above the 127 area at the 2758.15. Then on Friday, we got this strong gap up, and it seems like it is making its way up to this 161 at the 2912.19. So for the coming week, we're going to watch to see if the S&P 500 will push up to this 161 and encounter resistance. Then we pull back and see would it be able to break this trend line and come back down and possibly test this 2711 once again to see would it get some sort of a support and push us back up, or would it just continue to come down and come down to test this 100% at 2637.06 before it gets some potential support here and bounce back up. And that is a few scenarios to keep an eye on. And I think the key level to watch for the coming week is this 2912.19, or essentially this 38.2, somewhere around 2935 area. So we'll be watching 2935 to the 2912 area for potential resistance, and see what it pushes the pushes it back down and break this channel or this wedge here, because it is seems to be developing a wedge. So we're going to see would it be able to, you know, come down and break this wedge, and maybe it will push us down to retest this 2637.06 around this 100% here, and also in confluence with this 618 near the 2650. So there you have it, this week's stock market update and analysis. Thank you for watching. If you like the content in this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and also click the subscribe if you're not a subscriber to this channel. Thank you for watching, and keep that social distancing to keep yourself safe and keep others safe. Good luck.